Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm here with my hubby and I talked him into doing a mukbang. Woo! Introduce yourself.
I'm her husband. I agreed to this because I've been hungry since like 8-9 hours ago. So this has been a full stack of ribs slow cooking for like 4 hours. So I'm ready to just
hopefully doesn't disappoint. So today we're going to be eating pork ribs, and on the side I did some onions and carrot underneath, so that's cooked amazingly, very caramelized. Here we got a little bit of rice because I'm trying to be semi-healthy. Obviously that's not going to work, but anyways, some rice with mixed veggies inside. And here for all my Jamaican folks, I was craving chicken back. Not chicken, but chicken back. So I went ahead and made myself some spicy chicken back. Basically, I just seared up the chicken back and cook it down with some tomatoes and onion and peppers and thyme and all that good stuff. It's very spicy. It's good. Mostly bones, but that's straight up my alley. For him, pork ribs, obviously, I'll be trying that too. I got some red wine here, of course. This is Smoking Loon. The guy at the LCBO suggested this for me. I'm already halfway through it. And it's Cabernet Sauvignon. It's a good time. And Colin has the Coors Light over there.
No, Coors Banquet. Same thing, no? It's stronger than Coors Lights. Coors Banquet has less alcohol in it.
It's Coors Banquet. Anywho, we are going to dig in. I hope you guys enjoy this video.
I'm so hungry.
Right now I'm on some Bila vibes, so let's get to this. While we go through the video, we're going to probably have some conversation and stuff. We're just going with the flow, so let's get into the video, sisters and misters and everyone. So now Colin is going to be the tester for the ribs. Cut it between the bones, and you can do it. He's going to try and see how it is.
To this day, my dad still makes fun of me for how I cut stuff, so no one judge. Apparently, I don't cut things properly with a knife and a fork.
You don't. And when he's eating, he goes like,
well, whatever, it works, okay?
That shit annoys me. Works or not, it's annoying.
It smells so good.
Okay, you're going to try first before I even try it, because I want to know.
Do I use...
This is a mukbang. The messier, the better. People love when you're messy. We love a messy, messy king.
No, it
king.
Just fell right off the bone.
I know.
Okay, let's see. It's really good.
Out of 10.
It's also like a high 9.
What's really lacking?
Good. Well, I don't want to give you... I don't want to blow you up too much.
Okay. All right, so a little bit of rice here for me. I love rice. Honestly, guys, rice is my favorite thing on earth. If I had to pick one thing to survive on, it would be rice. Here we got a piece.
Not love from her husband, but rice.
I can't survive on your love.
All
That's
you
not going to fill my belly. Says who?
All you need is love.
Okay. Here we go. The nice piece of chicken back. No, we ain't poor. We just love chicken. I love chicken back. Growing up poor, this was a staple, my friend. So now, every time I eat this, it reminds me of home. Believe it or not. And I'm going to go in and get some of this nice caramelized onion with carrots. Yum. And a nice big chunk of this.
It's really good.
Pork. Come through.
It just falls right off the bone. Try it.
Chicken first. Okay, let's try the thing.
It's super tender.
That's yummy. Wow. This is my first time making you ribs.
I know.
In four years.
I wasn't a big rib guy ever. But this could definitely change my point of view.
Colin is like, he's really into like chicken wings and breast and stuff. But yeah, this is really good. I mean, I wouldn't cook this on the normal for me because I gain weight like this. And on the other hand, never.
I'm a skinny mini.
You are. That wine is good.
Oh no.
Let's try this onion. Babe, try that.
The onion?
Onion and
I know everyone's gonna judge me, but before I met my wife, I never had any sort of any type of onion in my entire life. Like in any sense. Caramelized or even on a burger at McDonald's, never had an onion in my entire life.
Fun fact, when I met Colin and I moved in, the only thing Colin had in his cupboard was salt. Literally. He had a big old kitchen and the only thing in his cupboard was salt. I kid you not, because he thinks black pepper is too spicy. He doesn't drink tea, so he never has sugar. So it was just salt. And when we went grocery shopping, Colin would get the same thing over and over. And then his grocery bill would be like almost $200. And that wouldn't last him the whole month for himself. Like, what the heck are you buying? Then he would get like bacon, shake and bake, chicken breasts, all these things. And then it was like, you would get two chicken breasts that's already deboned and everything for like, what, $14? When he could get like two chicken breasts on the bone for like half the price. So I had to upgrade him and I saved him a lot of money. So am I the best girlfriend or what? Well, wife now.
I've said that many times.
I know. But yeah.
But you still enjoy hearing it though.
Mm-hmm. I'm so used to saying girlfriend.
We've been married for like a year and a half though.
I know. It's so weird. I am a weirdo. Yummy. So in today's video, we're going to talk about what? I have some questions. I'm feeling like I want to ask him some like Jamaican slangs. I'm like interracial couple questions. Yeah, we're doing it. Let people get triggered. I know people will be triggered. I'm going to get messy because I know this is a mukbang. Here's a rib. I'm gonna bite it. Oh my goodness.
So what's your first question? Because I'm down for whatever, as long as the ribs keep coming to my plate.
Do you guys know that beloved chick? This is how she eats. It's kind of gross. She's worse than me, to be honest. But now, her channel has just been outrageous. She just had a collab with Patrick Starr of Fall Fucking 3. If you don't know who Patrick Starr is, then who the fuck are you?
I don't know who that is.
You wouldn't know. He's a makeup artist, but like, girls. If you don't know, then sis, what is your life? Anywho, I was surprised she had a collab with Patrick Starr, to be honest. But girl is moving up. We love a good hustler. So I'm happy for her.
So what's your first question?
Yum. I love bones.
Good God.
I love chewing on bones. Let's see. I think we're going to start off with some Jamaican slangs. I pulled it up on YouTube. Not YouTube. Google. Yeah.
Was this a full rack?
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Go, man, eat. Mega meat a little more.
You gonna eat your meat? Eat a little bit more meat?
Mega meat ya little more.
I'll meet you a little bit later?
Yes.
Yeah.
Good job. You know Wagwan.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Go on.
Colin. Wagwan.
What do you want?
Babe, you can't be with a Jamaican woman and you don't know what Wagwan mean. I tell you this all the time. Come on. No more ribs unless you know.
I thought it's being like, what's up or what's going on?
Yeah, it's what's up. That's not what you just said.
Excuse me, I'm close enough. I know what's going on.
Well, be specific, my friend. Next one, Medea.
Medea.
Medea. Medea, man. Wagwan, Medea, man.
How's your day going?
someone say, Wagwan, and then I'll be like, Medea, man, just a chill out.
It just means chill out?
No. I'm saying this, I'm giving you an example.
Well, I don't know, so tell me then.
You have to try.
Oh my God, man, put your damn glass on a coaster.
Medea.
So you have to deal with every day with this.
Medea.
Medea?
Medea, man.
Monday.
Wagwan. And then my reply would be, Medea.
Medea?
Medea. Medea. I'm here. I'm here.
Oh, well, that's pretty hard to understand.
Okay, love. Irie. You know Irie. What does Irie mean?
Good things.
Go on.
Positive vibes.
Feeling good. Positive vibes.
Scott, The Office. Little tiny break. That's when we'll put a little photo of him over our shoulder. Michael Scott with little braid.
My friend, this is a thing you go in. It's all bones, but there's a little bit of meat on there. Let's go in. Now I'm going to be asking Colin, well, asking us, Colin and myself, a couple of interracial questions, interracial couple questions, and we're going to discuss that. I've been munching on his bones because I have this weird obsession with bones. Like, I will literally, if we make wings, I will not even do a portion of wings for myself. I'll just eat on the bone. I know it's disgusting, but it's a long story. Don't judge me. Anyways, let's go. How do you feel about how much time we spend together?
I wish you had more time to spend together because life goes fast and we have to work and travel and it's tough.
You think we should spend more time together?
No, I think we spend quite a bit of time together, but I'm still saying I'd rather spend an extra 10 minutes with you than spend an hour at work. How romantic is that?
Oh. Are you just saying that because you think it's romantic?
No, it's truth.
Oh.
How
important is it to equally divvy up our chores?
Pretty important. You do the laundry and the dishes.
And I cook.
And you cook. Yeah, you cook. So that's...
The only thing Colin has over me is cleaning the washroom because I hate cleaning the washroom. So I'll do anything two times over.
But the washroom is all your hair, though. So it feels like it's all, you should be cleaning it.
No, it's a chance for you to connect with me more through my hair. How much alone time do you need?
How often, though? Like, in a week?
In a week. I would say one day for myself.
We'll
or at least or 2 days because I enjoy being a loner. Like, I love having alone time.
The good thing with us is Christelle's schedule is pretty set, but mine rotates and I work like crazy long hours and stuff. So every other week with my schedule, we actually get a bit of a break from each other, which is not a bad thing. Gives you a little bit of space.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think you and your partner share the same values? To an extent. Mm-hmm. To an extent. Some things that Colin thinks is like, that he values for me is just like, okay, whatever. But I mean, that stems from different upbringings and stuff. So, yeah. To an extent. How would you rate your kissing? I would say pretty good.
Very good.
Yeah, that's pretty good. When it comes to baby questions, how do you feel? Do you want kids? For the moment and for the future, probably not, honestly. Sometimes I feel like, oh, maybe I do. Like, I'm 90% or 95% I don't want. But then there's that, like, 5% where you see some very smart, brilliant fucking kids. And you're just like, shit, that could be my kid. And then I hang out with kids. And I'm just like, maybe I'll change my mind.
But we make some very, very, very pretty kids.
We would make gorgeous kids. But I feel like if anyone changes their mind, it would probably be me, because Colin is pretty set on young.
I like my time and
life.
And money.
We're just so... Forget money. Money comes and goes.
No. You need money to have kids.
No,
like,
you do money. No.
I like my money to be spent on us and just us and not struggle.
I get that, but like what I mean is like for me, it's more of like I like free will. I like my freedom.
That's good, too.
Yeah. For me, over money, it's like my freedom. I love having the... What is it? I love having...
The option?
The option to be like, oh, I can get up and go whenever I feel like. Yeah. But when you have a kid, you're like...
Not even just there. A kid, even pets.
But I still want a cat. Or two or three. I love cats. I feel like I crave cats more than I crave kids. I love cats. Cats are like my spirit animal. But yeah, kids for now is a no-no for us. Maybe in 20 years when I'm sterile. Who knows? But for now, I'm not a huge fan of kids. I love my nephews, though. They're cute.
I love my niece.
And yeah, his niece is like awesome. So, yeah, we love being aunts and uncles. We love spoiling them when we have the time. That's enough for us for now. What's the main way you show your love? Ooh, I like that one. Let me answer this. For me, it's through doing stuff. Like, making sure it's dinner. 95% of the time is good for, like, to take to work the next day. And, like, small stuff. For me, it's more small, detail stuff. For Colin, you answer. And then
I tell you look very pretty all the time, every day.
Oh!
And I grab ass. And I grab ass.
That's how you show your love?
Well, you still get my rocks going.
I feel like with Colin, he shows it more in the bigger way, but I feel like with me, I appreciate the small stuff more. I like the small things, but with Colin, it's like, oh,
no,
a vacation or something. With me, it's the small stuff like, ooh, I ran you a bath or cup of tea.
I get you flowers every other week all the time, and you love that.
That's a great one. Yeah. Guys, we have been together 4 years now. And Colin has gotten me flowers.
2005.
No.
Yeah, 2014. 2019 now.
2005?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. No. Damn, I feel old.
Flowers.
How big of a role does spirituality or religion plays in your life?
I'm not religious nor spiritual, so this is your question.
I now consider myself spiritual because I find that religion is very corrupted. And I know... Everywhere is corrupted in their own sense or everything, but I just find that religion is so corrupted. And I don't agree, like, I was raised Seventh-day Adventist. I don't agree with a lot of the stuff they teach, like, if, like, gay people or this get, like, abolished or going to hell or, like, all that dumb shit. I don't really believe in that, so I believe in spreading love and... Well, to an extent, you can't be fucking outrageous, because where do you draw the line? But long story short, I'm spiritual, and yeah, I'm not very religious, but I do believe there's a God. I don't believe you have to be of one faith to get to that God, but I do believe there's an higher power, yes. Colin, on the other hand, just believe in science, but to me, everything is flawed. Religion is flawed, so is science in a lot of ways. So to each their own, whatever floats your boat.
No, I'm not a Scientologist. Don't get that out there. What are you saying, science?
No, you believe in science. Like, you're not a Scientologist, but you believe, if it can be proven. But the point I was trying to make is science doesn't prove everything.
I just wish...
Everything is flawed.
I just I just wish everyone would get along, but religion is just power and corruption and money. That's all it comes
to. I feel like religion is more for separation than bringing people together.
Absolutely.
So that's... When you and your partner disagree, how do you... what do you say to resolve it? I yell. I cuss. I'll cuss from now till next year. I'm just being honest.
And I'll laugh, and then I guess you're even more upset.
Mm-hmm.
For me, like...
Damn, babe, you finished all the ribs.
I told you I was hungry. And it was
you want this last one?
That's all you. Go for it.
No, have it.
No, you made it.
This is my second rib. Colin killed it. Anyways, go.
For me, I laugh it off now. I try not to get too upset about things.
Yeah.
I used to hold grudges. I try not to anymore. So I try to be more positive.
Yeah, you definitely need to work on being more positive. Colin always looks at the negative side of everything. I look at the positive side of stuff, but Colin always focuses on the negative. I guess that's like opposite attract, but it's so annoying. Because I'm trying to be like, I've been negative in the past, but I'm trying to be like more positive, and it's hard to be more positive when you're with such like a person with negative views. But we're working on ourselves. And, yeah, I think we're growing as a couple. What do you like to do in your downtime?
Listen to music, play music on the guitar, and just relax and go to the gym.
For me, Netflix and chill with a glass of red wine. Simple. And the last question of the day, I think I'm going to turn my phone off for this one and ask this off the top of my head. Let's do a big vibe for you guys, because that's why you came here. Yes, queen. Last question. What do you enjoy the most about our relationship? That's off the top of my head.
Your sass. Which makes things interesting.
You like my sass?
Yes, and how much I know you love me. Mm-hmm. And your cute accent, because it makes me feel like I'm living on an island.
The stuff I love about him the most is also the stuff that I'm just like, I want to punch in the face. How lovey-dovey he is. Colin is like a little puppy dog. He's all up in your cribbits and corners. Sometimes I just want to punch him. Like, oh, get away from me.
I'm sorry, but if you're wearing something that pops your booty, I'm going to grab that booty as your husband. Mm. If you're wearing, like, something that doesn't show it, I'll be a little bit more... But if you're going to wear something that's popping, you best be realizing that I'll be grabbing that popping.
Note to self, dress like a grandma.
Ew. Mm. Little bed sheets.
Well, yeah. That's that. This has been successful. I'm full.
Ribs were delicious. Thank you for making them.
Okay, guys. So, sorry if this is an awkward ending, but time is of the essence. The video is finishing. Anywho, thank you guys so much for watching this mukbang with us. Mwah. It was fun. And, yeah, hopefully we'll do more mukbangs in the future. But that's that. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you like this. And for future videos, any final words, love?
No? Should be good to go.
Okay, guys. Thanks for watching again. And until next time, love you, lovelies.